Hi students, welcome back. In the previous class, we learned about agriculture progress in medieval India. Today, we are going to learn about handicraft and handiworks. Students, in previous class, you have gone through the agriculture progress in medieval India. Because of the expansion of agriculture, several industries were developed based on agriculture products. For example, products like oil seeds, sugarcane, indigo, and cotton led to the development of small-scale industries. So next, we are going to see different occupations led by the people of medieval India, like textile industry, production of silk, production of carpet and paper, metallurgy and mining, and salt production. Let's see first one, textile industry. The use of charkha was a key factor that facilitated the development of textile industry. From the 14th century onwards, charkha began to be used in India. Indians adopted this technology from the Chinese. The introduction of charkha increased the production of yarn 6 times more. Second one, production of silk. Weaving also advanced along with spinning. The invention of loom brought tremendous changes in weaving. The technology for the production of silk from silkworms also spread widely during that period. Bengal introduced the first production of silk in the 14th century. Third one, production of carpet and paper. The production of carpet and paper were other major handicraft. There was great demand for Indian carpets in the foreign market. In India, paper began to be used in the 13th century. Okay, next. Fourth one, metallurgy and mining. Metallurgy and mining industries that flourished in this period. Those who were engaged in metallurgy mostly produced agriculture tools and war equipment. The production of horseshoe and iron stirrup made drastic changes in war technology. Copper and gems were mined from Rajasthan and Golconda. Next, salt production. Salt production was important occupation that developed much in this period. Seashore, salt rocks, and salt lakes were the major sources of salt. West Punjab and Sambhar in Rajasthan were the chief salt producing centers. Next, let's see trade and commerce in medieval India. We have already studied that agriculture progress in medieval India. The surplus production helped the growth of commerce. The commercial centers in India attracted several traders from all over the world. Next, let's see major countries and their trade in India. The major countries that had trade relations with India during medieval period are Sumatra and Java in Indonesia. Second, Persia in present Iran. Third, Holland. Fourth, England. Fifth, China. Sixth, Portugal. And sixth, France. These are the major countries that had trade relations with India during medieval period. Next, let's see trade in India. India had inland trade and maritime trade relations with foreign countries. The two major inland trade routes were from Lahore in the present Pakistan to Kabul in the present Afghanistan and from Multan in the present Pakistan to Kandahar in the present Afghanistan. The maritime trade was also known as coastline trade. The major ports are first one Cambay, that is in Gujarat. Second one, Broach, that is in banks of Narmada River. Third one, Surat, Fourth one, Goa. Fifth one, Nagapattinam, that is in Tamil Nadu. Sixth one, Masulipattinam, that is in Andhra Pradesh. And seventh one, Kozhikode, it is in Kerala. And eighth one, Kollam, it is also in Kerala. Okay students, today we learned about handiwork and handicraft and trade and commerce in medieval period. Hope you all understood about today's topic. Thank you.